So today we're going to be doing some kitchen science. This week has been all about different kinds of food and activities we can do in our kitchen, and we're going to continue that today with one of my favorite kitchen science activities, and that would be pancakes. Pancakes are a great way to experiment in the kitchen, learn about chemistry, and make some yummy, tasty treats. So to get started, we're going to be using some ingredients. My first ingredient is actually some dry pancake mix. Now I'm gonna go ahead and add that in. That pancake mix has some flour and some sugar and some baking soda in there. And my pancake mix has me adding some milk in there next. So I'm gonna go ahead and pour that milk in, about a half a cup of milk. And then it has me adding in an egg. Not this egg. This egg. So I'm going to go ahead and add an egg into my pancake mix. And scientists, your pancake mix at home might be different, or you might be using different ingredients, and that's okay. It's nice to experiment and try different ingredients, and it's nice to use different recipes. We're also going to add just a little bit of cooking oil in there. And then I do have a secret Gretchen ingredient, and that would be vanilla. So we're going to add just a little bit of vanilla in there, and that gives it kind of a different flavor and a little bit of a nice smell. Now, again, scientists, your pancake mix might be different, or you might be using a different recipe. What's nice to do is to try different amounts of milk or different amounts of butter or different ingredients or reactants, and that can give you different types of pancakes. Now, I'm going to use my whisk to beat that around, but whoa. My whisk looks like it's also been stuck at home this week. There we go. So I'm going to use my whisk to stir around these ingredients. And scientists, in chemistry, we call ingredients reactants. So things like our flour mix and our egg and our oil, we call them reactants. That's just another word for ingredients. And when these ingredients or reactants stir together, we're trying to get them to change or do a chemical reaction. I'm getting a little tired. Oh my goodness. Now, scientists, as I do this, you can see I'm getting a very nice batter, a nice pancake batter. And what I'm looking to do in this chemical reaction is actually create some gas. I'm hoping to create some carbon dioxide gas that will make my pancakes nice and fluffy. Now, I've got a nice pancake mixture in there. But what I don't have are fluffy pancakes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and pour some of this pancake mixture into a pan that has been heated. So my pan has been heated. It's here on the stove. It's got just a little bit of oil in there, and that will allow us to start that chemical reaction and get those gas bubbles or those carbon dioxide bubbles cooking up and hopefully make us a nice pancake. I'm going to also pour my mixture or my pancake mix into the measuring cup so that it's a little bit safer. And just a reminder, scientists, when you're home doing this, you want to make sure that you are very careful with your stove because it gets very hot, and you want to work with your adult to make sure you stay safe and you're looking at your stove at all times. So I'm going to go ahead and pour that pancake mixture right into the pan. Woo! Got a little bit of heat going. And I'm going to grab my spatula to go ahead and start moving that pancake around just a little bit. Let me show you what that pancake looks like. And again, scientists, we're trying to see some of those bubbles. And the bubbles show us that there's gas, and that gas is carbon dioxide. Now, some people will actually add more of the baking soda or baking powder into their mixture, and that can cause you to get even fluffier pancakes. So you can go ahead and experiment with different ways to do it. So let me see if I can have you see my pancake a little bit closer. There you go. And I'm going to just kind of move it, give it a minute to fluff up. And while we're doing that, I'm actually going to show you a pancake I made just a little bit earlier. And hopefully you can enjoy my pancake. She loves science. All right, scientists, it was great to be here with you. The activity is on our website, so please make sure you check our website every weekday at 10 a.m. at the California Science Center to find new videos and new activities. And I hope this made you feel a little less stuck at home. Bye, scientists!
Be sure to visit our website Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. for more stuck-at-home science activities.